Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. I'm going to show you an easy way to multiply by 5. The idea is that 5 is the same thing as 1/2 times 10. In other words, it's half of 10. Okay, so this is the idea we're going to use. So let's say you wanted to do 22 times 5. I can write this 5 is 1/2 times 10, right? And then I can go left to right. 22 times a half, that's half of 22, that's just 11. And then when you multiply by 10, you get to just add a 0 to the end. Right now, I don't want you to write all this out. We're going to go directly to that. If you have 22 times 5, you're just going to take half of 22 and add a 0. That's all there is to it. It gets a little more complicated if it's not an even number, but we'll work into that. First, let's try some with even numbers. Okay, so how would we do 18 times 5? We would just take half of 18, which is 9, and add a 0. Because that's what happens when you have a whole number. When you multiply by 10, you just get to add a 0. All right, how about 14 times 5? Can you do that one? You just take half of 14, multiply by 10, which means you get to add a 0. How about 24 times 5? Can you do that one? You just take half of 24 and then add a 0. Now, when I say take half of something, you could think of it as dividing by 2, right? So 24 divided by 2 is 12. Either way you want to think about it. Let's do 66 times 5. Okay. 66 times 5. Well, what's half of 66? 33. And add a 0. See how easy that is? Try these. These are a little bit harder to take half of for some people, but you could divide by 2 if you want. All right, so 32 times 5, if you take half of 32, you get 16, add the 0. Half of 58. Now, half of 58 is 29, and add a 0. If you have trouble taking half of 58, try this. Can you do half of 50? Half of 50 is 25, and then do half of 8, which is 4, and add it together. Ah, hey, so there's a tricky way of taking half a number. But in any case, 58 times 5 is 290. All right, we're going to do ones where we have odd numbers, but first let's just do the even ones. Let's do 26 times 5 and 28 times 5, so try that. 26 times 5, you take half of 26, which is 13. Add a 0. 28 times 5, you take half of 28, which is 14, and add a 0. Now, when you multiply a number by 5, what it really means is you're doing 26 5s added together. And then, so if I wanted 27 5s added together, you get one more 5. This should be 135, 5 more. And then if you do 28 5s, 5 more than that is 140. And that's what we're going to think about when we have to take an odd number. So let's say I took 33 times 5. Well, it's easy to figure out 32 5s. So we'll take half of 32, all right? And then instead of just multiplying by 10, we're going to put a 5 at the end because it'll be, instead of 160, there's an extra 5 since it's an odd number. So we put a 5 at the end. So if you're doing an odd number, you go down to the next consecutive, integer down, so from 33 down to 32, take half of that and then add a 5 at the end instead of putting a 0 at the end. So try this. Let's say you had 17 times 5. You would want to take half of 16. All right, what's half of 16? 8. But it's an odd number, so you're going to have, instead of 80, it'll be 85. Right? Let's do 25 times 5. All right, so it's an odd number. You want to take half of the even number. So half of 24 is 12. And then add a 5 instead of a 0 at the end. How about 40? Let's do 3. 43 times 5. So we want to take half of 42, which is 21, and add a 5 at the end. So that's what you do if you have an odd number times 5. Try these four problems, see how quickly you can get the answers. All right, so 27 times 5, you want to take half of 26, which is 13, put a 5 at the end. 37 times 5, you want to take half of 36, which is 18, put a 5 at the end. 49 times 5, you want to take half of 48, which is 24, put a 5 at the end. And 53 times 5, take half of 52, which is 26, put a 5 at the end. And again, half of 36 some people have trouble with, and half of 52, you might have to divide by 2. And so your question is it easier to divide by 2 or take and multiply this number by 5 the long way? That's really your, you know, decision, which is the quick and fast way for you to do it. The other way you could do it is if you don't want to take half of the number first, you could multiply by 10 and then take half. So if you have 27 times 5, you can multiply by 10 first and then divide by 2, and you'll still get 135. 37 times 5, you can multiply by 10 first and then divide by 2. If that's easier for you, you can do it that way. 49 times 5, you can multiply by 10 and then divide by 2. 53 times 5, you could add 0, in other words, and then divide by 2. That's what's happening when you're multiplying by 10. You're putting a 0 at the end and divide. So it's just an alternative way as opposed to just doing the multiplication with 5. Most people could do it in your head, doing it either this way, thinking 270 divided by 2, or just taking half of 26 and putting a 5 at the end. This also works with decimals, but I'm going to do that on another video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.